Today we are going to discuss an important disease, that is the tetanus. Tetanus is an acute disease caused by exotoxin of Clostridium tetani. It is clinically characterized by muscular rigidity, which persists throughout the illness, characterized by painful paroxysmal spasm of the voluntary muscles, especially the masseters, and it leads to trisomus or lockjaw. Spasm of the facial muscles resulting into risus sardonicus, the muscles of the back and neck spasm, and it is resulting in opisthotonus and those of the lower limb and abdomen. Mortality rate is very much high in this disease, varying from 40 to 80%. This is the patient of risus sardonicus. A person from the tetanus undergoes convulsive muscle contractions of the jaw, that is known as lockjaw. Opisthotonus. The contractions by the muscles of the back and extremities leading to opisthotonus. The tetanus was first described by Hippocrates in Greek era. Etiology of tetanus was discovered in 1884 by Paul. Passive immunity used for treatment and prophylaxis during World War I. Tetanus toxoid first widely used during World War II. Tetanus is still very common in third world countries, causing several hundred thousand deaths per year. Tetanus is now comparatively rare disease in the developed nation. Neonatal tetanus is killer disease, second only to measles among the 9 target diseases in EPR in Pakistan. But now there are 10 EPR diseases against which the vaccines are being given to the newborn. Even with treatment, the case fatality rate can be as high as 80 to 90%. Tetanus tends to occur in areas with poor access to health care. Therefore, it often remains hidden within the community. Currently, surveys has consistently shown that only a small proportion of neonatal tetanus cases are routinely reported to modifiable disease surveillance system in most developing countries. Underreporting is often highest in underserved areas at highest risk of neonatal tetanus. So there are many remote areas from which the data is not coming of this disease. That's why underreporting is often occurring, and that's why the actual number is not being identified. During 2008, a total of 16,628 cases of tetanus and 6,058 cases of neonatal tetanus were reported to WHO worldwide. World Health Organization announced the target to eliminate neonatal tetanus in 1995 to reduce the incidence to less than one case per 1,000 live births. Tetanus is an important endemic infection in Pakistan. It means This disease is occurring throughout the year in the country. Behaviors such as delivery practices, traditional birth customs, and less interest in immunization are all important factors affecting the disease incidence. Poor health services, that is the underserved areas, and the livestock regions around the globe are two conditions particularly associated to neonatal tetanus. Since 1983, the nationwide EPI has recommended the provision of two doses of tetanus toxoid to all pregnant women during each pregnancy. One booster dose is required if less than 3 years have passed since the previous pregnancy to prevent neonatal and maternal tetanus. In addition to immunization, hospitals and primary health centers where clean deliveries can be performed should be established to reduce the incidence and prevalence of the disease. A cadre of trained community midwives and other birth attendants should be developed to ensure clean and safe delivery and cord care practices. As far as the agent of the disease is concerned, Clostridium tetani is a gram-positive anaerobic spore-forming bacteria. The spores are terminal and give an organism a domestic appearance. Multiple toxins are produced with the growth of bacteria. So this is the microscopic picture of Clostridium tetani with gram stain. There are two forms of the bacteria. One is sporulated and other one, that is the vegetative form. And this vegetative form is responsible for development of the disease. The resistance. The spores are highly resistant to boiling, phenol, crystal, and autoclaving. They germinate under anaerobic conditions and produce a potent exotoxin that is known as tetanospasmin. So this bacteria germinate or grows in anaerobic conditions, means without oxygen. The spores are best destroyed by steam under pressure at 120 degrees centigrade for 20 minutes or by gamma radiations. The reservoir of infection. The natural habitat of the organism is soil and dust. So the bacteria is mostly found in the soil and dust around the atmosphere. The bacilli are found in the intestine of many herbivorous animals, for example, cattle, horse, goats, and sheep. The bacilli are excreted in feces, and the spores survive for many years in the nature. So these are the causes and reservoirs of the spores or bacteria of the disease. The bacilli may be found frequently in the intestine of men without causing ill effects. The spores are found in dust and may be present in wide variety of places, even including operation theaters. Exotoxins. The tetanus bacilli produce a potent soluble exotoxin, that is tetanospasmin. It has a high lethal toxicity. Lethal dose of a 70 kg adult person is about 0.1 milligram. The tetanus toxin acts on four areas of nervous system. First, on motor end plates in skeletal system. Second, on spinal cord. On third, on the brain. And fourth, on the sympathetic system of the body. Its principal action is to block inhibition of the spinal reflexes. It is not transmitted from person to person. Anaerobic conditions allow germination of spores and production of toxins. It means without oxygen, there is a germination of the spores and it leads to production of many toxins. And these toxins binds in central nervous system of the body. And it interferes with the neurotransmitter release to block inhibitor impulses, leads to unopposed muscle contractions and spasm. So this is the mechanism of action of tetanus toxin. So here the Clostridium tetani is affecting or blocking the inhibitory impulses. Commonly, tetanus is a disease of active age from 5 to 40 years. This period predisposes to all kinds of trauma. Therefore, the risk of acquiring the disease is very high. Tetanus occurring in newborn is known as neonatal tetanus. Infants typically contract the disease at birth. When delivered in non-aseptic conditions, especially when the umbilical cord is cut with unclean instrument, or when the umbilical stump is dressed with ashes, soil, or cow dung. A higher incidence is found in males. Males appear to be more sensitive to tetanus toxin than females. Females are more exposed to the risk of tetanus, especially during delivery or abortion, leading to puerperal tetanus. Agriculture workers are at special risk because of their contact with soil is more frequent than other occupations. The incidence of tetanus is much lower in urban than in rural areas. No age is immune unless protected by previous immunization. The immunity resulting from two injections of tetanus toxoid is highly effective and lasting for 7 years. As a general rule, patients who have recovered from tetanus must be actively immunized because the amount of toxin responsible for the disease in men do not stimulate protective immunity. Immunity lasting for a few weeks, less than 6 months in mother, can be transferred to the baby if the mother is immunized during pregnancy or if she already has a high level of immunity at the time when she becomes pregnant. Tetanus is one disease in which herd immunity does not protect the individuals. So the herd immunity has no role in the tetanus disease prevention. But in polio and other diseases, herd immunity plays an important role in the prevention. Environmental and social factors also play an important role. Tetanus occurrence depends upon man's physical and ecological surroundings, atmosphere, that is the soil, agriculture, animal husbandry. The environmental factors are compounded by social factors, such as unhygienic customs and habits. For example, application of dust and animal dung to the wounds, unhygienic delivery practices, using unsterilized instruments for cutting the umbilical cord, ignorance of infection and lack of primary health care services. In developed nations, urbanization, industrialization, and mechanization of agriculture have interfered with the normal process of distribution of Clostridium tetani and have reduced the morbidity. For example, in UK, America, and Germany. The mode of transmission. Infection is acquired by contamination of wounds with tetanus spores. The range of injuries and accidents which may lead to tetanus comprise a silent pinprick, skin abrasions, puncture wounds and burns, animal bites and stings, unsterile surgery, intrauterine death and bowel surgery, dental extractions and injections, unsterile division of umbilical cord, compound fractures, otitis media, chronic skin ulcers, eye infections, and gangrenous limb. The incubation period ranges from 6 to 10 days. It ranges from 1 day to as long as several months. There are 5 types of tetanus. One is traumatic tetanus, in which the trauma is a major and important cause of tetanus. Sometimes tetanus may result from most slight or even unnoticed wounds. The second one, that is the purpural sepsis. Tetanus follows abortion more frequently than a normal labor. A post-abortive uterus is a favorable site for the germination of tetanus spores. The third one, that is otogenic, here may be a real port of entry. Foreign bodies such as infected pencils, matches, and beads may introduce the infection. It is more common in children. Idiopathic, in which there is no one cause is identified. No definite history of sustaining an injury. Some consider it from a result of microscopic trauma. The fifth one, that is tetanus neonatorum. In many countries, neonatal tetanus kills about 85% of those affected children. The common cause is infection of the umbilical stump after birth. The first symptom is being seen about after 7th day. So, this disease is also known as 8th day disease. In any country like Pakistan, where hygiene is poor, neonatal tetanus will be common. So, a child suffering from neonatal tetanus. The signs and symptoms of the disease. There will be burning of lips, burning of fingers, burning feet, painful hand muscles, painful foot muscles, painful facial muscles, difficulty in opening the mouth, rapid breathing, vomiting, and other symptoms include excessive sweating, fever, hand or foot spasm, irritability. There will be swallowing difficulty, even uncontrolled urination or defecation. So the sequence of events, so there can be a spasm. It will lead to muscle rigidity. It will lead to difficulty in swallowing, even stiff neck and locked jaw. The diagnosis of tetanus is made on the basis of history and clinical findings. The tetanus is suspected upon exposure to bite or puncture wound. It is diagnosed by the on the basis of history and clinical findings, because Clostridium tetani exhibits such a delicate sensitivity to oxygen, it is very difficult to grow from clinical specimen. As far as the prevention is concerned, there is an active immunization and passive immunization. The active immunization is done by tetanus toxoid vaccine. It stimulates the production of protective antitoxins. There are two preparations which are available for active immunization. One is combined vaccination in the form of DPT, but now it is in the pentavalent vaccine. And other one, that is the monovalent vaccine, and it is of two types, plain or fluid toxoid. Other one, that is the purified tetanus vaccine. The combined vaccine, tetanus vaccine, is often offered routinely to infants in EPR. It is given in combination with four other vaccines in pentavalent. Penta vaccine, which are diphtheria, pertussis, hepatitis, and H influenza vaccine. It is given in three doses on 6th week, on 10th week, and 14th week of the birth of the child. Monovalent vaccine, that is the purified tetanus toxoid vaccine, has a largely replaced the plain toxoid vaccine because it stimulates a higher and longer lasting immunity response than plain toxoid. A primary course of immunization consists of 5 doses commonly given to all childbearing age girls and women, and the age starts from 15 up to 49 years of age. Each dose is 0.5 mm injected into the arm by intramuscular injections. The schedule of childbearing age TT vaccine is: the first dose is given at the first contact, and the second dose is given after 1 month of the first dose, and third dose is being given after the 6 month of second dose. Fourth dose is given after the 1 year of third dose, and the final and fifth dose is given after 1 year of the fourth dose. Reactions after tetanus toxoid vaccinations are uncommon. Although persons giving history of allergy, usual precautions should be taken. The passive immunization, it is a temporary protection provided by two types of injections. One is human tetanus hyperimmunoglobulin, and the second one is anti-tetanus serum. The human tetanus hyperimmunoglobulin is best prophylactic to use. The dose of all ages is 250 international units. It does not cause serum reactions. It gives a longer passive protection, up to 30 days or more. And if human antitoxin is not available, anti-tetanus serum ATS should be used. The standard dose is 1500 international units injected subcutaneously after sensitivity testing, means after test dose. ATS gives passive protection for about 7 to 10 days. The active and passive immunization. The simultaneous active and passive immunization is widely carried out in non-immunized person. The patient is given 1500 units of ATS or 250 units of human immunoglobulin in one arm and 0.5 ml of absorbed tetanus toxoid into the other arm or gluteal region. This should be followed 6 weeks later by another dose of 0.5 ml of tetanus toxoid and third dose 1 year later. The purpose of antitoxin is for immediate temporary protection, and the purpose of the toxoid vaccine is for long-lasting protection. Antibiotics are indicated in the prophylaxis against tetanus. A single intramuscular injection of 1.2 megauniters of long-acting penicillin provide a sustained concentration of the drug for 3 to 4 weeks, sufficient to kill vegetative forms of tetanus bacilli. Penicillin has no effect on tetanus spores. Sensitive to penicillin patients are given the course of erythromycin. The prevention of neonatal tetanus. Neonatal tetanus is well controlled in industrialized countries through clean and safe delivery practices alone. Most of deaths worldwide are occurring in developing nations. Over the last decade, most programs in developing countries have concentrated on training of traditional birth attendants, means the community midwives. Training of community midwives. The second one, providing home delivery kits to pregnant women and educating pregnant women about the three cleans. And what are these three cleans? Clean hands, clean delivery surface, and clean cord care. Clean blade for the cutting the cord, clean tie for the cord, no application on the cord stem. Operational research has shown that training of birth attendants alone can reduce deaths due to neonatal tetanus by 90%. Tetanus toxoid vaccine to mothers will protect both the mother as well as her child. In unimmunized pregnant women, two doses of PT should be given first dose as early as possible during the pregnancy, and the second dose at least a month later or at least 3 weeks before the delivery. In previously immunized pregnant women, a booster dose is considered sufficient. The infants born to the mothers who have not previously received 2 doses of tetanus toxoid are exposed to increased risk of neonatal tetanus. They are protected by injections of antitoxin. If it is administered within 6 hours of birth. All surgical wounds should receive surgical toilet. Wounds less than 6 hours old should be thoroughly cleaned soon after injury. Removal of foreign bodies, soil, dust, and necrotic tissue. This procedure will abolish anaerobic conditions which favors germination of tetanus spores, resulting in the formation of toxins. So proper management of wounds is very much necessary. As far as the treatment is concerned, very difficult to treat the disease once symptoms have developed. Death may occur from tetanus, often from cardiac and respiratory effects. Neutralization of unbound toxin with human tetanus immunoglobulin is being done, and prevention of further toxin production is done by wound debridement and giving the antibiotics. The spasm is being controlled by good nursing in quiet environment, avoiding unnecessary stimuli, protecting the airway, and supportive care is being given by adequate hydration and proper nutrition, treating the secondary infection, and even prevention of bed sores. Thank you.